All right, hello, it's Sara. Not sure if it's a great idea right now. Matt's mowing. But I've just mixed some white, titanium white paint with a textile medium. I gotta put my apron on real quick. I'm kind of doing a bunch of things at once, but I kind of wanted to prep this. This is, I believe, another piece of duck cloth, but it's blue, or it may be denim. I bought it a while ago when I was doing Midori's, and it's been sitting, so I wanted to paint it. I took some of this textile medium, it's called Fabric Painting Medium by Americana, and it says to mix paint 2-to-1 with the medium. And I didn't measure. I just squirted some out and mixed some white in. And I happen to be using this Josonia Titanium White because I have it. And it's a pretty heavy-bodied paint. So I wanted something because, I was going to do gesso just to get it because I wanted white. And gesso specifically says stiffens. And the fabric's going to be stiff enough as it is. This is a pretty stiff fabric. And I don't need tooth because it's already got tooth. So I just decided to try this because I had it again. I've painted on fabric before. I have a bag over there I'll show you in a minute. But I'm just going to get some of this pushed into the fabric and give it a little background because I'm going to use this for, again, stamping off and see what happens, because it seems like a lot of the best, happiest accidents are coming from the stamping off technique that everyone does, so in mixed media. So that was my thought with that. I need a little bit more. What else was I going to say? I went to Michael's yesterday. I just wanted to get a couple more paint colors. I got a fluorescent pink and a fluorescent orange just in the craft paints. And these make market surfaces were on 70% off, and I would have bought more, but I bought all they had. I'll show you in a second, because I think they're going to be great for putting tiles on, and I'm pretty sure what I'm going to use these for is the style of mosaic frame. I'm getting it all over me that I did this. So it's all wood, and you can put the tiles all the way around it. So this one happens to be five. I got 2 5x7s and an 8x10, and I really wish they had more. And I don't have any other Michaels near me. There was one about a half an hour from here. They closed. That's where the new Hobby Lobby is. So, and then I was just in Maryland and we were in a Michaels, and it stinks, but. And you know what else we don't have is Tuesday morning. I wish we had Tuesday morning because it would just be fun to go in there and have a look sometimes. I mean, I'm not really trying to buy a lot of stuff, but sometimes when you can find things for 70% off, I mean, that, you know, things that I'm pretty sure I'm going to use. So that's all I'm doing to this. I'm going to set it aside to dry. Sorry, Kiwi. Kiwi's with me. I got to get all this crap off my desk. We're out of the way. I have, and then I went through, and these are actually fabrics that they put on my dog after she's been groomed. And I've been taking, and they're the cutest. This is actually not from like PetSmart or something. PetSmart always puts just the PetSmart one. This was when I was taking her to a different groomer. And she put these really cute fabrics. Like, these are super cute. And I could get a small faux dory out of these. So I was putting, anyway. But I'm going to keep these on hand and maybe, I don't know, maybe I'll do something to them, maybe I won't. And this is little sugar skulls on flowers with a black background. So I just pulled these out to have them around me because I did another piece of fabric. This is just, I had shared, Gina Ahrens had done a video called Sewing 101, and she did this little pencil bag. So I made one, and this is how it turned out. I didn't leave, you can kind of see I put this little jump ring down here. It's not really doing anything, but I had to cut the zipper because I didn't use enough fabric. It seems to be, it's working. I mean, it's fine. As long as you don't yank it, you're not going to pull it off. Like, if you just close it like that, you know, calmly. So I made that little pencil bag. And then I just did this piece of fabric, which is a much bigger piece. So I wanted to make sure that my zippers are in the other room. But yeah, for a 9-inch zipper, I think this should be better. And I just did this the same way. I'll do a little more on here and show you what I did. I just started adding color basically the same exact way as I would do something like this. So this is the fabric version of this watercolor paper. So I just, first I add some paint and then I add some stamping, and that's basically it. But I love adding metallic paint, so I have these leaves are in metallic. I have gold dots, and that's basically it in the metallic. And I think it turned out pretty good. I'm not sure about the purple. Adding purple, you have to use cool colors together and warm colors together because they don't tend to mix and you can get mud. I mean, a lot, the purple looks pretty purple. It doesn't look muddy, so I was pretty happy with that. But, and if you did, like, see, I think in places where it did look muddy, I just put a big circle of white. So, but yeah, I think, and I think I'm going to make a pencil case with this. I was thinking of sewing something to it. So maybe a piece of this. So basically, you could cut a heart out of this, this little bird, OMG, and put it on there. Should I do that? I think I want to do that. we'll think about it. You know what? I could paint a bird. I could paint a bird on here, right? So that's what I was going to show you guys. So because I've just gotten a couple questions about, you know, watching me do it. So why don't we use some of these new colors that I got? Let's paint. I'll make this video in a minute. I'll make a tutorial on how to make these foam stamps. They're super simple. So I'm going to put out a few colors of paint. This is my paint palette. It's called a paper palette. And let's see if there's a, oh, nope. Sometimes there's a paper fluorescent orange, Bahama blue, and again, guys, use what you have if, you know, and use what you like. Oh, I didn't shake this one. People ask, what color was that? What color? And half the time, I don't even look at the name. I just look at the bottle and see if it's something that I like and use it. And if I like it, I use it. So, use what you like. I tend to stick to bright color. I like bright color. It's not for everyone, but I always end up going back to that. Look at that fluorescent pink. Now, here's the thing. We have a dark blue background. Maybe it'll look good with fluorescent, you know, colors. I don't know. I kind of want to use just a scraping tool. So I think I'm going to get like an old credit card and just use that. Grab some paint and just scrape it on here in a few different places. Really? No rhyme or reason. You know what else? And if you guys haven't watched Tiffany's videos, you really should, because she really puts into words what a lot of you guys are wondering and thinking. And I think that's fantastic, but she says something like, you got to get through the ugly phase. And there is always an ugly phase where you think, this is not going to work, you know? I've got to move some more stuff. The other thing I was going to say was I told you guys, I have my composition book. This is my, where I would roll my brayer after jelly printing. And I'm just going to stamp off in here and try to use up extra paint or whatever. I don't know. But I'm trying to keep this out so that I remember to do that, because I'm a paint waster. I don't tend to remember to do that. So this blue is super pretty. But it just totally covered the orange, which is okay. You can always add more. I'm really just trying to get every bit of the paint off my palette. So see how that's looking? Gorgeous. Now, I'm going to save the fluorescent pink for last. So let's put some green. Uh-oh, what happens when you do green and blue? Mud? I don't know. And turn it. Turn it. That's another thing. You watch people, I wish I could think of her name. The latest class on Lifebook did a background, and she uses a square canvas purposely so that she doesn't have, there's no top and no bottom. So she can just, whatever side appeals to her, she's gonna choose. And you know, square, being a square, it's easier to do that. So maybe I should have cut this into a square. I want green right here. And here. And here. We got a little pink on there already. I'm excited. All right. So that's what it looks like so far. The ugly phase, right? Ugly stage. I'm going to put some fluorescent pink on here. Oh shit. I just got my napkin in it. I'll scrape it off. Oh, this is glittery. I can see the glitter. Oh, it's not showing up really well as a primary color. Ooh, but I can see the glitter. So I'm basically putting this over any white sections that are left, because I think it's going to show up the best on the white. Wow. Oh, look at that. Just a little bit. There's a lot of glitter though. Can you see? Yeah, you can see all that glitter. Ooh. All right, what do I want to do? Add a little bit of yellow. I think I want to add yellow. And I just use any yellow that I happen to have. This one's called cadmium yellow. But I think I want to add a little yellow. I don't know why, because I love color. And this might be way too many colors. I don't know. Man, that is sparkly. That pink. All right, so I'm just going to add yellow. I'm going to try and cover up some of the blue with yellow. And I'm using this scraping technique because it's fabric. It's got so much, there's fibers. And so a brush is just going to go over the top of the fibers. This kind of pushes the paint down into the fibers. That's my thought anyway. And because I use the textile medium, hopefully I've sealed it so that it's okay to, whatever. I don't know. I don't really know. You know. Just wanted to bring some of the color out to the edges, too. Aha! Is it still looking hideous? I'm hideous. Oh, man, I'm getting it on my, I don't like to get it on my Fiskars cutting mat. So I'm going to try and get it off with a wet wipe. Sorry. I like to keep it as neat as possible. This is sliding over. All right. I got a lot of yellow on my table. Now we need to do a few metallics. You know what? I want to go back. Look at the pink. Can you see? I'll go in a little. Look at the glitter. Oh, yeah. Oh, that is so glittery. Wow. What? That is awesome. Oops, too close. All right, I think I need something. I need some more white, probably. And then we could start doing some stamping. See, there's a lot of good white here. I'm going to put some of that pink right there. See this section right here? It's white. So I'm going to put pink glitter. I might have to go back and get a few more colors of this. The glittery stuff. Woohoo! I love glitter. I love sparkle. I love diamonds. I wish I could afford them. If I was like rich, super rich, I think I would just wear all diamond jewelry. Like I'd have a diamond, well this one's diamonds, but it's just chips. I have 3 holes in each ear. I would have diamonds in every hole. I would have like a nice diamond pendant. Oh yeah. I love them. I love diamonds. I love bling. Something needs to be. I think I'm going to go put some white out. So yeah, I mean it's a process and I should speed this up because this is really all I'm doing is scraping on paint. It's not rocket science. But I'm going to put some more white here because I just feel like it got too solid, and some here. Heavy body paint is good for this because you don't always want to use gesso. I was using gesso a lot for white because I don't know, I have a whole huge bottle of it. But it's a different texture than a heavy body paint, so. All right, I'm gonna go away and come back when I'm ready to start stamping. All right, see you in a minute. All right, that's enough of a background. I just kind of evened it out, I think. But that's the very bottom. And we can always add to that. But What I've done is I've pulled out my Jacquard Lemur paints by Jacquard, they're called. And these are metallic fabric paints. They're light body, so they're kind of sheer. But I'm going to put some marks on here with those. I'm going to add metallic. So I want to use this big circle that I have. I'm going to use this purple. Even though there's no purple on here, and it's sheer enough that I think it'll play. And it's not going to mix. So I'm just going to put some of that out on my palette and make a little stamping block type area. So this is what I'm doing. Spreading it on here. I'll scrape that back in the jar. And then I'm going to use this. Hopefully it'll make some nice big circles. Look at that. And these could get covered up, so I'm not, you know, I don't care where what they're doing right now. Ooh, I like this. Stamp. It's a stamp. Because this is a big enough canvas, I don't have to use small stuff, that's all. Like, a lot of my mark making tools are small because I'm working in a smaller area, but because this is a bigger canvas, this is at least like 16 by 14. It's pretty big. I'm just free to use bigger things. I don't really want to put another one, and I inked this up. Ah! So I have to get my book. Where's my book? Right here. So I get my book out and just use up this paint in here. Aha! That's what you do. I'll leave some of it out on my palette too, and I'll maybe use it again in a different color. There you go. See? Oops. And I should clean that off because I don't want to get it on everything. Try to keep it to the book. Ooh. Kind of making my book purple now. That's fine. Alright. So I messed that up, but that's okay because this is the very first thing we're doing. I want to do black. You know what I want to do first though? No, I want to do black. And black is great to add, but I want to do a couple flat. Look at this big flower. Should I do this big flower? I have three flowers that I made. These are the foam stamps. I don't think I want to add black with these though. I could. I like this one with black. I think I want to add like a bright fuchsia with this. So I'm going to make another stamping section I'm going to go with my bright, this is called Royal Fuchsia. I don't know why. Maybe I'm getting crazy, but I'm going to make another stamping area. Just and again, these stamps don't have to come out perfect. Like, I don't need to have every petal, but I'm going to put it. See? It's just a hint. Can you see it? And I got a fingerprint. That's a fingerprint. But this is when it starts to come together. And pretty soon those colors that we put down in the background are just going to be that. They're just going to be background color that pops through. I may outline some of these flowers with black. And I gotta get my book. I don't know where I put it. I don't want to get purple all over it again. This page I went a little crazy. But then you stamp off. And I think I do want to put black on here. But look, it's starting to come together already. Yellow and green. I know what I want to do with green. I'm going to use some more metallic paint. The Lemire. This is one of my favorite colors. Halo Blue Gold. And I'm going to put some leaves. I carved my own leaves out of the Ready Carve or whatever it's called. Now I just got to find them. I have this big leaf and I have a smaller leaf that I carved. So and you can tell I've used the jacquard. It's shiny. It's so pretty. So I'll put this. Oh, I should shake it. I'll put this near. Now listen, I just happen to have these, but you can use any color you hit. It doesn't have to be metallic at all. It can be a regular green because it's going to do the same thing. But look at this. It's blue-green. So you see the blue and the green? It's crazy. It's so pretty. I love it. Whenever I'm doing dragonflies, I usually paint their wings this color for their bodies. So let me put a few of these bigger leaves next to the flowers. Ah! Where stuff is going to start falling. I want to put a little one next to the big ones. I'm going to put this right here. Cute, right? And this is kind of the top, so that's backwards. Doesn't matter at all. But I did have a top and a bottom, kind of like the way the veins of the leaf go, kind of designates the top and the bottom. OMG. It just starts to look like something, you know, even though it was just a bunch of colors. I think it starts to look like something. And it could just be this. This could be the design, like flowers and leaves. I have a ton of purple paint over here. So I'm going to set that aside. Stamp it off. I'm just stamping it off. And I have a smaller one I want to do. Like I said, there's like a total lump of paint right here. I just want to dry it. I should smudge it somewhere. Yeah, I don't know if that was good. But you know what? This isn't going to be... I'm going to cut this up. So I don't have to worry about the overall really as much. Because when you cut it up into... for parts, it'll be exactly what I want. So I'll put a little leaf next to the big leaves. So you guys get the idea. See, look, there's a big hunk of purple there too. I have that Coldplay song stuck in my head. I feel my heart beating. Anyway, that happens, you know. All right, so I have some leaves. I love this color so much. Color just gets me excited. I don't know. It really stimulates me somehow. All right, so there's that. Can you see those leaves? And you know what? We may outline them later. And that way, they'll show up a little more. And I want to put gold, but you know what? I want to put black. I gotta remember, I want to put black, 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 black. What should I do? Something big. You know what? Circles. Circles are good with black. I have this circle stamp. I wonder if that would be too much. You know what's good? You know what? Maybe I'll put a few of these smaller flowers that I... This one. I'm going to do a couple of black ones of these. Yeah. Black is just... It's awesome because it makes everything else seem brighter somehow. I don't know. So I'm going to, again, make a little palette in black. And... stamp some of these guys. We can doodle around these with white. One of the petals is not getting painty. Why aren't you getting painty? There we go. I try not to think, but I think. I try not to, like, I just have to. I don't know why. This is so cool. I don't mean to sing, because I really can't sing. But that's just a happiness noise, kind of. I'm stamping off the edges. I don't think that's nearly enough black, but man... Oh wow, it looks really good in the on film. All right, so I'm stamping off this book. I kind of want to finish these off. Beautiful day today. I walked Kirby a little while ago and I was sweating, but still it was beautiful. Nice breeze. I kind of want to outline. I want to put some more fuchsia. I'm looking for like a number three round or something like that. Yep, one of these to just put a little more fuchsia on here. I mean, it could still get covered up because by the time I'm done doing stuff, who knows what I'm gonna do. I could tell you stuff. I could just talk about things. I go to the gym now and I'm already feeling better. I feel like I'm starting to get stronger. I'm doing a little weight training and some cardio, so that's definitely, I need that. When I don't do it, I don't feel as good. So just like a half an hour every other day, and I am enjoying it. Although I went to the weight training for seniors class last Friday, and I'm going tomorrow. And man, they kicked my ass. They totally kicked my ass. And I was had to be the youngest. I'm 52. And it's really for like 55 and over. But man, it's an hour of just continuous movement, and there was at least 12 of us in there or more, men and women, and they were killing it. Killing it. All right, what else should I do? It's more circles. So basically, I'm going to go away. Oh, you know what I'm going to do? This one. I like this one in black. Although it looks very similar. But I also like doing solid circles and then circling around them. And to do that, I'll show you that. Let's do that in white. I do like white, but I could do yellow. I want to bring back some gold. Oh my gosh, let's do gold. Sorry, I got excited. All right, so gold circles we're going to do. Definitely going to make a little painterly pile of gold paint over here, kind of thick, because I'm gonna use the back of a cap to make these circles, and so like one of these. Yeah, look at that, that's big. This is a Snapple cap, so I'm just gonna get that coated in some paint and plunk it down. It worked. And plunk it down. It's it kind of rolls up at the edges, so sometimes you don't get a very crisp looking circle, but it's circular enough. And then we're gonna go back with black. I'll show you. And go around it. I could go back with white. Nah, I think I'm gonna do black. And we'll do white with other stuff. We'll do white, don't worry. So I have that many. I need one over here. Over here. And turning. Something like right around. Right there. Right in the middle of there. Can always add more, but that's good. Now I'm gonna take the same lid. Hopefully I have enough black. I might need put a little more out and go around it with black and define that circle. I think I need a little more, but I don't know. I like the crisp line. I like it to look crisp, so I just added a little more black, and it's probably too much now. Ooh, spatter. That just spattered a little and reminded me of spatter. Ooh, drippage. What about drippage? Do we want to put drippage? I could put drippage. Look at that. That looks cool, doesn't it? I think I need one more over here somewhere, right? Like right here. Whoopsie. That's a lot of black. Right there, and that's good. Oops, stamp it off. stamp it off. I'm loving the stamping off now that I'm thinking of it. I used to just rub it, like, you know, wipe it. So I gotta do one more gold spot right over here. Doggone it. Oh, you know what else we could use? Like silver. I never use silver. Sorry, I get so excited. All right, so you know what? Should I go away? This is getting long now, isn't it? Isn't that what happens? I just keep, oh look, I'm just gonna use my palette and scrape some of that gold on here. Why not? I don't know. Nobody told me not to. So I did it. All right, and then I'm gonna take that cap, fill in this little stinking spot right here. Lovely. Oh, stamp it off. Stamp it off. And white. I definitely got to add more white, like specific white. You got to let this dry a little bit. I'll be right back. Okay, I think I'm done, but right now I'm just going back and outlining these the very first flowers that I put on here. I just feel like it got way too busy. It got away from me. This one is much calmer. It has, basically it's just the colors in the background and then it's got circles and that's it. Like that's the whole design. And it's this one got away from me a little bit. So I just want to pull some things from the background a little bit. These flowers will give our eyes something to hold on to, I think. I went crazy. I absolutely went crazy. I stamped my little heart out. I'll show you. But I think this is going to, because I didn't go crazy with the black. I outlined circles with the black. I love how that looks, like outlining all the circles. And I just did that one black flower that I think I'm going to outline that with white. I could actually use a different color too. But, so I'm pretty happy about that. So let's see. Oh, I have a couple more over here. But I think, here, I'll just stop. What other metallic? I put, because the pink totally went away, like I'm pulling it back up now with the black, I added these two littler flowers, and that's like a mix of metallic paint and the fuchsia. And I may outline them, but I think I might leave them in the background. I did yellow dots all over the place and did an outline of pink. I did blue stamping with my number stamp to bring the blue back. I loved the white. This is a stamp that I carved myself. And I definitely saw it somewhere. I didn't think of it myself. Where the heck is it? It's like a, I don't know. I'll find it. But it's this shape right here. I love that on, I did that in black on this one. And I just put like gold dots on each end of it. But I love that on here. So that kind of looked like a little bit of a flowery effect too. What else did I do? Just lots of circles. I focused on the circles. The purple kind of went away. I ended up stamping a lot of circles on that purple circle. So I think the last thing I'm going to do, if anything, is add a little more purple somehow. Maybe just spatter. I really don't know. What else? I went around the centers of the black with yellow. I did black dots with my stamp. So I like it. Let me go back up. I probably lost a lot of the glitter. No, it's still there. When you see it close up, there's a lot of glitter actually, just coming from the background. Maybe I'll just put glitter here too. here and here. Like, I might just make spots of glitter. We'll see. But I like it. And it started blue, and now it looks like that. And I can do whatever I want with this. I can cut pieces of it out and put it on other pieces of art, or make it into a bag or something else. Cut a piece of it and just use that as a cover to a art journal or something. So that's how I paint fabric. I don't think I'm gonna seal it, although I don't think it would hurt if I actually, I could just probably use, I forget what it's called, but I have a spray. I don't think I'm gonna seal it. I'm gonna leave it the way it is. Although if you use it, you should probably seal it. Oh, let me go get my bag that I did. And I might have showed this in another video, but I painted this at Chapter when I belonged to the painting chapter. And I don't remember who the artist is that created it, the design, because it's not my design. It's my little patriotic mice. And this is a denim tote bag that I got. I don't remember where. I mean, it's just from AC Moore or Michaels, somewhere. I picked it up somewhere. But it's my little red, white, and blue, my mouse parade. And to do this, basically you just mix the fabric medium, textile medium, in with your paints. And once you get it base coated, then, I mean, I even floated on here. You know, I did my shading and everything like I would normally on a piece of paper. But I've had this for years. I don't see a date because I never freaking put the date on anything, and I should. And you know, I don't use it too much. I do use it from time to time, but I love it. So you can paint on all types of things, guys. I mean, I might just go get a tote bag. That's a great idea. They have them cheap, and with a gift card, or I mean not a gift card, with a coupon, right? You can get it cheap. And then you'll have a tote bag that looks like this. That's pretty cool, right? To have your own artwork like that. All right, so that's it. I know it was long. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day, and thanks for watching.